Hello everyone, how are you doing? Jackie B here. Well, it's not raining, but it's not really sunshiny either. A little bit of clouds. It has been staying light until past 9 o'clock. You would think it was summer, but we are in Oregon. Give you just a second to catch up and for me to get my computer so I can see what we're doing. Make sure I stay on camera, as it were. Hope you're having a great day. And I hope you like this video. Let me know if you do. Let me know if you try it. If you try it, put it down below. And that would be great. Alright, looks like we're pretty good. Maybe move this up a smidge. Make sure I stay in camera. All right, so you can't see my shopping site, but I think a lot of you know. Thank you ever so much for supporting my business, JackieBloom.closetomyheartCTMH.com. That's where you can shop for all the supplies you see today. Okay, get that out of the way. All right, a couple of housekeeping tips to let you know about. There is a retired list for the core catalog. That's our yearly one, which is... this one. Ooh, sorry about that glare. See if I can get that down a little bit. So that's that one. And there's a lot on here. There's a lot going, double-sided, and a lot coming. Okay? And there's a few, we always update, I guess is the best way to say, our color palette. So we will be losing the color of the year, obviously, because it's only around for a year. And then we're going to be losing 5 other colors, but we're going to be getting some really pretty ones. All right, the next thing to tell you about is Stamptacular. This is a stamp sale. It has these 5 exclusive stamps to the sale. It's while supplies are available, or June 30th, whichever comes first. Okay, and they're pretty heavily discounted, up to almost half price, I believe, on some of them. And what I wanted to show you is that there's some really old ones, stamps that were favorites. There's some current ones, that's all these yellow ones. There's a ton of stamps, there's all the yellow ones. And, oh, let me go back. So right here, it says level 1 savings, $5 instead of $8. This one is level 2 savings instead of, they're $10 instead of, I think the biggest one I found was $21.95 for 10 bucks. Very nice. The third savings is a $15 sale price, and the highest of those, I believe, was, well, here's a $30.95 for 15, so that's about half price right there. Okay, let's see. Nope, I didn't show you this side. Sorry. And if you need anything, just let me know, and I can let you know if it's on sale, if there's a favorite stamp set you want. The next level is level 4, so these are $20 sale price, and they are up to $30.95 regularly. And that continues on here. Let's see, what did I say, 30? This one is $33.95 for 20, so that's nice. Oh, this one, let's see if there's any more. Oh, okay, so for 20 bucks, this one was $38.95 regularly. Now remember, when you buy these, you're going to pay your shipping on the regular price. And the last one is level 5 for $25, and I believe the biggest one I found there was $36.95. Yeah, $36.95. Yeah, I think that's about the biggest. And then there's a level 6 for $30, And there is one that's almost 40, which those are great. And then there's even a level 7 for $35 instead of $40, which this is the one I used for my last card class. And each one of these are a good size, and each one of these pawn fronds has a thin cut. Okay, so enough of the business stuff. Let's get to the pretty stuff. Let's see. Anybody out there? Can't tell. Can never tell on my phone. And my computer doesn't seem to alert me either. So, something that I am always using, but I'm going to give you a word of caution today. Tweezers. Close to my heart tweezers are very sharp, hence the Band-Aid. So when you store them, do not store them up like this and go grab them. Store them down. And if you have that little cover that goes over them, even better. I have lost mine. Enough said about that. The next thing that I'm going to show you is the Quickie Glue Pen. Quick, meaning it's going to dry fast. So you need to be quick. And it is right here. And it is $4.95. And it's a very pinpoint size. But for this today, it works great. Get that out of the way. Okay. And a couple other things I'm using is my piercing tool. It's got a stylus on one end and a very sharp, even sharper than the tweezers. So I always store it like this. It did have a gray cap and I had it for the longest time. I would take it off of here and put it on here, but I've lost it. Our Teflon coated scissors, which are sticky proof. And if they do get sticky, you can just wipe them off. I usually use our our gum eraser, Write and Rub eraser or something. And that'll take it right off, okay? But it takes a long time before they get sticky. Then I'm using some of our glue, which is the white glue that dries clear, which I like. I don't know if you guys noticed, but there's a small end for pinpoint and a bigger end, which I forget to use this a lot of the times. Our new mono adhesive, permanent adhesive. Love this stuff, Air Touch. It works so nice. And the refill, you get a 2-pack. Yay. All right. So my inspiration for today, let me talk about the stamp sets. This first one is with thin cuts. That's why it looks like this. Z4442, Coffee Happens. Okay. And here's some cards that I have done before with this Coffee Happens. Make sure that I stay on camera. And I'll bring them up. So here's two that I did. So I did that one. Some of that new thin cut there. The double doily pack and the great big one. Here's another one. Love the mocha glitter paper. And I even put the mocha shimmer pin on there. And I cut the little circles out with my hole punch. And then the card that kind of gave me the inspiration today was this one. Okay. And it was this in particular that I said, oh, I saw something. I'll put it in the notes down below, which Close to My Heart consultant had done a video. Hers was quite a bit different than what I'm doing. But that's what gave me the idea. And then this gave me a nice color palette. And where I got this from is from the Hope and Kindness special, and this is the one right here. Okay, and then on the back side is just plain paper and your zip strip, pretty zip strip. But it's nice, we can use the cut aparts, and you can use them other than a picture frame, you know, to mount a 4x6 photo. You can cut it up and do whatever. And then the other part, stick that away in there. Pull this one out. There's like 3 specialty papers in here. Let me pull out the other one too. And there is a sticker sheet with or without sticker sheet. You can get it or not get it. And you can see it online on the catalog, or just put in hope and kindness. So there's 3 of them that are kind of like this. Like this, you could use this totally, right? Cut it up into squares and stuff, or strips. But then if you don't want that, here's just your regular page. And then this one, I use this little one right here. You are amazing on today's card. And then again, the back is just a texture. And it's got a nice little pattern that you probably can't see because it's pretty small, so I'll hold it up. And there's the zip strip, hopefully, coming into view. Yes. Okay. That out of the way. That out of the way. And then I took this, which is the thin cut for thanks. It's the word thanks. Z3684. And it's got the negative and the letters, the positive, if you will. So your shadow piece and then your layering letters, okay? And that's really nice because how you would normally use these is black and white, just like that. So it punches out the one whole shape of the background, the negative, and then each individual letter with this one, okay? And then you can also do color on color. This is the light side of sage and desert rose. Okay. So there's kind of what you would think die cut you would use. Okay. You could also use the light and the dark of the paper because remember it's full strength on one side, 30% lighter. So you could use full strength in the background and the lighter on top too. So I guess that would have been another one. All right. Standard way. Now the Jackie twist. And thanks to that consultant, I will get her name. So, I wanted to go through the colors that we are using, which are right here. Peach, Sundance, Desert Rose, Sage, and Harbor. Okay? And I'm going to stack those up. Just how I'm going to use them. And then this stamp set. And this isn't the one that the gal used on the video, but it's the one that I'm using today, which this is in the core catalog, and it is B1799 Brush Strokes. It's also got a nice happy birthday, thank you, miss you, little baby words in there. And I love all these, the detail. See all that detail in there that it looks like it's, what would you say, like light and dark? It's going to give you that when you stamp with it. It's so cool. Okay? Alright. So, let's get started. I have a white background. And try not to lose them. White letters. So, this is what they look like when you stamp them in white. Okay? It's just kind of white on white. Nothing special. Right? I'm going to set those aside for now, and we're going to do this one, and I'm going to turn it this way. Make sure I'm on camera. Sorry about the white on white. Let me see what I can do about that. I'm going to pull out my VersaMat, which this side is great for scrapbooking and lining stuff up. And cutting, it's a forgiving mat. And then this side is squishy and will give us so you can see what I'm doing. Alright, there we go. So I'm going to take the first color. Let me see how best to do this. Keep on camera. I'm just going to go like this. Okay, and this is peach. I'm going to ink it up and I'm going to stamp on there. So it doesn't, I didn't do all of it, but it is peach. Okay, wash that off. And I'm going to set this upside down so I can keep them in order and don't have to think about it. Then I'm going to take Sundance. I'm going to, this is how I stamped it the first time, so I want to rotate it. And I'm going to stamp that. Now, I really like this little tip at the in, and it's great for going back and adding just a little bit. Okay, and since I'm using this, I'm going to wash that off. I don't want to mix my colors too much, and we're going to move over. Wash and move. Ugh, I just got ink all over the back of that. Wash that off. Make sure there's none of my fingers. Okay, Desert Rose is next. And again, we're going to use that little bit because I love it. Okay. And this one's not coming out just like the other one. I mean, they're all going to kind of be organic and be different. Okay. So just, that's just how it is. Okay. You move over here. You can still see me. Turn my stamp around again. And this time I think I'm going to do two. No, I'm not going to do two of that. I'll do one. And that was Sage ink. And now we are using Harbor. And that's a little darker color, so it doesn't matter. Turn your stamp around. Like so. Add the little bit. Add the little bit. Oop, add a little bit more. Okay. Let's move again. Because that's a dark color, and we're going to go back to the light color. So let's wash that area off. Wash that area off. I should have done this on my all-purpose mat, but... Alright, so we're going to go back to peach. How are you liking it so far? Got a little air bubble. I got a little air bubble in there, so I want to pull it out and push it out. Okay, it was working fine, but I don't know. Bugged me. Alrighty, let's go here and do a little more there. Okay, and I wanted to do it so that way I didn't end up with this on each end. So it's kind of why I just did one of each color, but you could do whatever you want. And our last little color doesn't matter because the other color down is a light color. Okay. And then we'll stack those back up so they're in line. And minus all my dirty fingers, that's what you get. Okay? And I have a little bit of overbelly, but I think it'll be fine. All right, so I'm going to take, let me wipe this off, take this away for just a second. Bring this back in, and our letters back in, and I'm going to show you a couple things to do. I'm going to turn them over upside down, and I'm going to use my tweezers and my quick glue. Okay, remember, quick. You've got to be quick. So, the best way that I found to help me, because this is heaven to Betsy, that's hard to hold on to. So I'm going to hold it to that way I can turn it over and place it to where I can see. So I'm doing it the opposite. Get my quick glue out, which is very fine. I hold it down. And if you tap it to get it going, you can see that it's blue. Hopefully. Let me see. Put a little more on. And so you want to just get your glue on there quickly before it starts to fade. Okay, let's see if you can see that. I'll have to take a still shot. And if you want to get more on there, you just tap it and hold it, and then it will put more on there. Okay, so then this helps us to put that on, and I put a block on it to hold it while I get my next letter. And that way it seats down both ends of the letter. We'll go on to the next one. I'm not going to do all of these because I have one made, but it's just that easy. So that's one way to put your letters on. Oops. Okay. I missed the H. And the bigger letters, you know, they look kind of intimidating. They're actually easier. Okay. So you don't need to watch me glue that because I'll be gluing some more. And what you are left with when you get all done putting that together, is this. Isn't that pretty? Now, you could also go and add dots to these letters with a journaling pen, or lines, or stripes, or plaid, or whatever you wanted. But I just kind of like it like that. I think it looks pretty. Yeah, let me put it on a color. Like so. How's that? Now, you could go and put sparkles on this. You could put shimmer. You could do a shimmer color or the clear on there. This will be a bonus card, so I will make this into a card. I do have a card to show you, though, so don't fret. All right, so the next thing we're going to do something different, get all those out of the way, is I'm going to bring in this. Now, this is, anybody know what this is? Who knows what this is? I'll give you a second while I get it ready. Ah, and it is sticky. So what is it, everybody? It is, let me see if anybody said anything. Nope. It is press and seal. You never know when you're going to find something somewhere else, kitchen, garage. You know, we use all kinds of tools. So I've got my black outline, and I'm going to put that underneath. Okay. And then I'm going to put my letters on top. This is where your tweezers come in handy. And all I want to do is line them up. And I had some trouble before, so I think I'm going to do this. There. Because it is very sticky, and if your hands are dry, you can hear it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just lining them up. Remember the negative thank you is underneath. Come on. Cooperate. Oh, see, and it shifted a little. There we go. And then our A. All I'm doing is getting these lined up so I can stamp on them. But I want them to kind of be, where are they going to be? And it'll make more sense in just a second. Okay. Put our pretty K on. And our S. And the S only goes one way. So that's kind of helpful. And we've got to figure out which way that is. That way. Alright, so I'm going to take these away. Got that on there. I don't need this anymore. And we'll just make sure that they're all down. So when we stamp, it'll work. Okay. We're going to stamp again. But this time, we're going to use Peach, Sundance, and Desert Rose only. Okay? And it'll make more sense in a second. So I'm going to take my Peach, and I am going to stamp. And this is where it's sticky, but, you know, you just, it really helps. And I'm just going across the letters, kind of, and you could line them up on your sheets there. Okay, so I've got the first layer on as it sticks to me. Good press and seal. Ah, bad press and seal. Okay, let's see what we can do. Let's try and put that down there. There we go. I didn't think of this earlier. Put this. Ugh, sorry. There. There. That's a little better. I like that. Okay. Next color. There we go. Well, kind of like that. There. About halfway. And turn it around. Okay. Like that. Wash that off. Last color. I'm going to wash it off because this color is a little darker than this one. And last color on there. So I'm just kind of going straight across. Like so. Yay. Okay. Wash that off. Alright. So now, I'm going to pull this back out. Because I need it. There we go. Because we have ink over there, I want to move my letters. And if you just slide your tweezers underneath, it'll lift it up. And it is still a little bit wet, but I'm going to reverse them on here. Okay? So I'm moving them off from where all of that was. Cautiously, because this is, you know, got lots of stuff on it. Get all bent. And it doesn't matter if they don't have to be lined up right now. I just want them to stick. And I'm only going to show you a couple that way. Because it might help you. I'll put the rest out here. There you go. One more. Sorry. One of these days I need to learn how to speed it up. Okay. But what I wanted to show you is that you can take your damp rag and clean off your press and seal. And ta-da! Can let it dry and use it again. It's the same one I used this morning. Okay, so why did I stick those two letters on there? Because if you have a hard time holding scissors and holding tweezers and holding your letters, you can just stick them down there. Stick. And you can take your glue pen and you can just glue them on the sticky on the press and seal. Then you can pick it up with your tweezers. And put it on your letter. So, there's my block. Put the block down. So you get the idea of that. So I'm not going to take the time to do these. Because I want to show you something else. Get rid of my press and seal. Put it on the edge of the table here. Stick. Okay. So the other thing is, if you want to raise this up, it's going to be a little bit hard to get foam tape in here. So the easiest thing to do, take some of this glue, which is the white that turns clear, and then we also have clear that kind of gets shiny, so you want to make sure that it's not showing if you don't want the shiny. And then I just simply take a couple of these, and this is only one, this is what I had left, and just mirror it on the back of here, like so. And then by the time you get another one on there, it beefs up the thickness of it. So that way it looks really good. And I wanted to show you I used this Stampin' Thin Cut from the special of that paper that I showed you. And it is CC. That means you know it's a special. Also CC, you know you're not going to get instructions with, because it was too quick of a turnaround time to get them proofed and ready and printed and in the bag. But you can print the instructions to whatever the special has, that whether it's cards, albums, scrapbooks, mini albums, online when you buy them. When you go to your cart, there's a little place down on the right that says print instructions. So this one is CC5225, okay, and the card I made for you today is this one. So this uses the little baby single flower, and I used the little "You are amazing, thanks, you are amazing" right there. And then I cut up that other, that's it. And then this is part of the paper that's in there. And I wanted to show you that close up because there is a pattern on there. So it's just a nice subtle pattern. Give you a good look. And this is raised up, but this is almost, hopefully, see if I can get to where you can see that. You can see there's three layers of the black on there. So it makes it nice and flat and sturdy, but raised. And then I added a little bit of the black and white dots, if you're interested, Z3314. And there's all different sizes. There's a small, medium, and a large. And so I just kind of sprinkle those around and think of triangles, which can be long triangles or true triangles or extended triangles. And that's the card I have for you today. And I will, like I said, this one I'll make a bonus card with. And I'm going to use, where'd it go? I'm going to use the coffee card with this one. So that one you can look forward to today. And I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you had a great day. Hey, Dolores, thanks for watching. Missed you last time at card class. And have a great weekend, everyone. Bye.